Spare key is tied. What? Gabriel. Can we open it from this side?
You see a heavy steel door with a prominent dimple lock. It's painted blue.
There must be a key somewhere. Probably somewhere in the whirling. It's not too important. We can get in and out using the roof door.
This small elevator is dimly lit by a bulb that's been glowing for ages. The latticed cage is smells of nougat and sweat. Your head brushes up against the ceiling. There is a control panel to your right. The maintenance card under the control panel reads, last maintenance, 10th July, 88. This elevator must have been used to transport pinball machines to and from the upstairs workshop.
Seems so, although it's pretty quaint for a freight elevator. That it does. I say, let's brave it.
The elevator was maintained in the future.
No, it was maintained in 88 of the previous century.
So it's not a message from the future.
No, I think the bureaucrats just forgot about this backroom elevator after the revolution.
There are large rectangular buttons. Monter, descend, and an international call for emergency assistance. That third one appears to be broken. A small steel plaque reads Halter 800. Halter is a Koningsteiner lift company who went out of business a long, long time ago.
Yep. Should I do the window?
This window visual is pristine calculus. On the inside, and the golden light melts away into the blue, glassy darkness of your mind. In it are two neon-lit shapes, a man and a woman on the single bed. A two-hearted spider. Like the witness said, the man is kneeling, the woman is on her back. It's the night of March 4th, and a shot has just been fired. The man looks directly at the woman. The shot's possible directions converge in his mouth, a ray cast from somewhere outside, entering his brain. From the roof outside, location A prime, the glass fractures around the bullet hole, shards face inwards like a corona behind the woman's back. The man does not know the bullet has entered his brain. He never will. Death comes faster than the realization. The ray cast from the man's mouth unravels into a fan of possible directions, all on the roof at first. The shot could have come from any of them. This is composite location A prime, most likely of the origin points. There could have been. Then the rain and slush and wind washed it away. This was more than a week ago. 72%, with an antique weapon that fires military-grade ammunition, a Belmer Grave rifle, for example. This is a good short distance, but not too short. The perpetrator aimed with their back against the railing, or possibly kneeling for precision. This would explain why it only took them one shot. The lights were on in here. Outside it was dark. It was like shooting fish in an aquarium. A well-lit aquarium. The victim opened his mouth to let the bullet in. Neither of them would have seen anything outside in the darkness. Too busy with their own bodies.
The shot come from the inside the room, closer point.
Point X would contradict the woman's testimony, rendering the entire proposition void. These figures would be wiped out, detective.
And the argument against A prime, the roof?
None that you've found thus far, but that doesn't mean there aren't any. That's a 28%, yes. In this model, the shot could have come from a greater distance. Nothing excludes the possibility. Should we extrapolate to include every possible point of origin in Martinez?
Yep.
According to your map of the district, this shot could have come from a wide angle of locations, starting with the northern edge of the abandoned boardwalk, ending with an islet in the bay. Let's call them B prime. B prime for boardwalk, B double prime for land's end, and B triple prime for the islet, detective. There may be smaller points in between, but those are too fine to zoom in on. 700 meters away, the likeliest of these B positions, 20% chance. A skilled sniper could have made the shot, provided he had a safe sniper's nest. Even with the light on inside, we're talking military training. At that distance, the perpetrator would have had to take wind direction into account.
I believe it was shot from there, north of the church.
kilometers away, the least likely of these positions, let's say 3%. A truly skilled sniper could have done it, possibly from a tent. No, too far-fetched. 1 kilometer away, a point beyond the docks, on an islet in the bay. The fort is ruined, but the perpetrator may have found a stable spot on the beaches surrounding it, where the concrete crumbles into the sea, as you saw in the coin-operated viewer. The shot would have been a small miracle, 5% likelihood. There is an extremely narrow field of view from the bay to the window, Between Rue de Saint-Ghislain 10 and 33A, the angle would have been extreme, and access to the islets is questionable.
From where, precisely? I see you have given this a lot of thought. Are those the locations you've singled out in addition to the roof? And what is the likelihood, in your opinion, that it came from a further distance? Okay, well, we should see if there is gunshot residue or a sniper nest if we go down the coast. Rule these spots out one by one. It would be the diligent thing to do. Until then, personally, I'm going with the roof version. It fits the hidden path through the whirling. A simple hypothesis.
Too hardy, boys. We need to find out where the leader is. One more corpse to inspect. Now there's actually a lot to do.
It's you again. What is it?
Up to Glacia. Wanted up to Rabbi.
Why?
Ah, there's the lorry driver. Holy shit. The quest from day one. She's your real leader?
You're cuckoo, cop. I'm the only man responsible for this unit. Get with it, or fuck off.
Yeah, fuck off!
Sounds like you're making her a suspect in this. Not on my watch, you're not. Ruby's one of us. We're not gonna throw her under your moral intern steamroller. Fuck that shit.
And fuck you too, moral fa-
Ruby is missing. If you hide from the police in a murder investigation, you become a suspect. You know how it works, guys.
That's nothing. That's just legalese. You don't even have a sound theory. I don't want to be rude, but we're trying to get some R&R here. Think you could fuck off now?
I think we'll keep sticking around, Titus. You'll be surprised at how quickly a theory presents itself if you keep looking.
Nothing is happening. The pieces are there, but they remain unconnected.
Come on, you fucking game, it's 92%. Fucking hell. I get it if it was 9, not 92. Like, what on fucking earth?
It's you again. What is it? Why? You're...
Yeah!
Sounds like Ruby... That...
I think we'll keep sticking...
A sudden flash of lightning in your neocortex. The hostel cafeteria is lit by its airy blaze. Floor plans, bullet trajectories, webs of human emotion, all channeled into a single thought.
Because she was here, all night, with us.
He's cobbling together shit so he can put her away. It's cop 101.
She was here all night? 12:25 to 12:15? She was here during all that time?
Yeah, with us, drinking, near the stage there.
She didn't go to the toilet?
No.
That's a lie.
All right, she took a fucking leak, okay? For one moment, maybe went out too. She has a complex operation to run from her lorry. She's a busy girl. Always has been.
Of course. Ruby is the lady driver in this great big jam mystery. Probably. You'll have to keep investigating. They'll never open up about it.
Just because she was gone for 5 minutes doesn't mean she magically got to the roof and shot the Merc. I've been through this. It's not plausible.
He's been through it. That means he suspected her too. All right, we're in. We got Ruby unaccounted for sometime during the window. This was crucial. Now let's place her on that roof.
There's a secret route in the kitchen that leads straight to the roof.
How? Oh. People say there was a pinball arcade here, sometime before the hostel. What was it called, Theo?
East Delta Pinball Arcade. Weird place. Went bankrupt.
Okay, but how'd you get up? There's no room for a staircase in this building, or an elevator for that matter.
The elevator is outside the building. It's an old dumbwaiter used for moving pinball machines up and down from the workshop. Ruby could have gone up, shot him, come down. All under 7 minutes.
That's quite the theory. We need to have a look at that secret passage, boys.
I'm on it, boss. Right when the law clears, me and Angus are going up there.
It's a dumbwaiter, not an industrial lift. How about I go instead of...
Just now. You got something else to back this route up? Or is that it? Firmly doesn't go well with could've. There's a route to the roof. Me and the boys need to check it out. That's what we established. But a route does not put that bullet in his head. A gun does that. And Ruby doesn't carry one.
Phase 2. Murder weapon. Get a gun in her hand. If not that, then at least a shadow of a doubt. In the shape of a gun. Just don't contradict yourself. If it doesn't sound like Ruby did it, maybe keep it to yourself. But what if you miss interesting information that way? The choice is ultimately yours. But...
First, show them the antique rifle.
That looks antique. A Bell McGrave. It's inoperable. Where'd you get it?
Cellar under the bookshop.
20, maybe 30 rifle status. Also broken, but still, there were too many. And there must be other caches too.
God damn it. We need to close that dump down for good.
Okay, I see your point. There are guns lying around. Damn it. I thought we'd found all the old spots. Why was that still there?
We just missed one. Ruby doesn't know this place, boss. Just these cops digging up shit.
Analyze the bullet that killed him, it was jacketed.
So it had to come from a breech-loading rifle. Military grade. Not even you militia monkeys have those. This goes against your short-range theory. If the murder weapon was military grade, how did Ruby get it?
You just showed him a breech loading gun.
just showed you?
A broken old broomstick is what you showed me. Good point taken.
Time to really close the deal. Show them the bullet.
Hold out the bullet. 446.
The blonde man looks at the mushroomed deathbringer in the evidence bag and says,
"Yeah, the bitch is jacketed all right. 4mm too.
Whoa.
Well, goddamn. It's not proof. It's a possible murder weapon. Close to her. Too damn close. You have been thorough. I'll give you that."
Is this ever sure anyone can get a gun?
Look, fucko. Ruby and I are pretty tight. She would have shown me the gun if she had one. She knows I love guns.
Yeah, everyone knows Glenn loves guns.
I don't know, Glennie. Ruby's a little secretive, isn't she? Wasn't like she told you every little thing.
Look who's finally speaking. Ratty's been uncharacteristically quiet since you started theorizing. Maybe he has something to gain from implicating her.
Plus, you said Ruby takes care of things. You don't do that without a gun in the shop.
She organizes things. She doesn't whack people. That's not the kind of person she is. She's a talker.
It's clear this one is protective of her.
Easy now, Glenn. What he's trying to say is, people who don't have guns don't shoot people. You need a gun for that. But you can't prove she has one.
You don't need to prove anything. Doubt is enough for now, and Titus must have some.
Small chance that a shot came from the roof.
Now what the hell are we supposed to do with that?
70% chance it did.
He's trying to woo us with cop science, forensic shit. I heard this mambo jambo.
Yeah, but the mambo jambo he's saying goes against his theory A.
It does?
Yes.
Just making sure we are on the same page. It doesn't all fit. We are just sharing info, candidly.
You lost your gun?
What an idiot!
Tell me, did you lose it before the murder? Sure. Take your sorry ass out of here. Ruby didn't use your lost gun to kill him.
Stop thinking about your lost gun, dammit. You'll get a heart attack.
This was merely a thought exercise. He did not lose his gun. Let's move on.
I don't know, cop. Why don't you find your lost gun first?
Hey, lost gun right here. Lost and found.
Easy now, Al. This isn't comedy hour.
Titus, we're not seriously considering it, are we? Ruby wouldn't do this. Why would she do something like this?
Phase 3. Motive. The last component.
And I suppose you have a theory on that.
Think about it. Why go through all that effort? It was her idea, wasn't it? The hanging. You went along, but she suggested it.
She had, like, a fully formed plan and shit. Right when she came back downstairs.
Really, Shanks? Clausia wanted to talk to another girl, that's all. She was just the first one up there. I could have come up with that plan if I'd have been first.
Time for a logics demonstration.
You're on thin ice here, asshole.
It's a thought exercise, Titus. Think. You kill him. Get up there. Shoot him. Get down.
alone. I don't drag my men into shit with me.
If she used us, then that's a serious violation of the Hardy Code, boss.
But she didn't. She would never do that. Why aren't more of you defending her? This is fucking stupid, Titus.
Glenn, I thought the same thing when she skipped town and left us in this shit.
Oh, so he didn't rule her out completely. And she skipped town. This is good.
There's no fucking leadership challenge. Just when I thought you were taking this seriously, cop, you put your head in your ass.
Man, now he's just throwing shit against the wall to see what sticks.
Okay. We've ruled out infighting. That's how this works, by exclusion. Remember, all we need to do is rule Ruby out too. That's all this is.
Silence. He looks around the room. The old man in the corner nods. A very small nod. And a trickle of tobacco spit on his lip.
Yeah, I see it. There's one more thing I've been wondering about. Ever since you asked me where she is. Add it to your list of suspicions, if you won't. I don't know. I don't know where she went. She just got up and left. Got real scared, too. Wouldn't tell me where. However hard I asked. Want to know why? She was afraid I would tell you. Maybe she was right. By now, I probably would.
She knew there's evidence on her, and she knew we'd find it. This is typical suspect behavior. Why fleeing is always incriminatory.
Perhaps. Ask her if you find her. It won't be easy, though. She made sure of that. Friday afternoon, when you first arrived, I got word the RCM was in town. Then she came in to see me. Told me she was leaving. That's when we had our little conversation. I told you. You. No, you. As in the cop with the sideburns and the disco clothes. It seems you have that effect, especially on women.
Right. That's the second one now who's trying to flee you.
You know, when I first saw you limping here, I thought she was paranoid or sniffing her own supply. But now I'm not so sure. She said you have a funny taste in clothes and that you won't stop until you have something on her. She said she's heard of you from Jamrock, that you're a human can opener, that you play suspects against each other, open them up, like cans.
And then when they're all empty, just move on, onto the next can. Don't look back unless there was something you missed.
Fucking hell. Titus, did he just...
open Angus up like a can? Yes, he did. Now, we can whine about it, whack him, or we can go on with our lives. I'm having to go on with our lives kind of day, Al. How about you?
Silence. He nods.
Am I a can opener?
You are insistent.
Yeah, there was something else. She wouldn't tell me, though. I could see she wanted to. It was burning on her lips. This cop, Titus. This cop, he... But she was too scared.
Scared? You should be, too. A strange fear creeps over you. A metallic taste in your mouth. Change the subject.
She's not far. We know that much. She didn't take her lorry. So, she's on foot.
Good fucking luck, man. She knows this place like the back of her hand. You'll never find her.
Yeah, Al. And we won't either.
She's not really a Hardy candidate anymore, is she?
She's not, Glenn. A little. On the coast.
Where have you looked for her, more precisely?
More precisely? On the coast, past the waterlog. She's not here. So, I'm thinking she's there.
Who's doing this looking? They're all here.
Who's looking up?
Lizzie needed some air.
She went to Televract. So she didn't go to Televract.
No one goes to tell Everard anything. He knows what he has to know. Fast.
It's called a radio, you believe. The gardener may have played you a game when she stormed out. She has her own plan.
Where on the coast?
Sure. There are some shit houses there. A cinder block town. Fisher folk there refuse to unionize. So that's one place we haven't looked. I hear they have a shack where junkies sometimes crash. Time for you to step up.
We will start there. One more question. What does Ruby look like?
Boyish. Hair's red. Dyed. She looks like a Lowry man. It'll have to.
His grip is firm and reassuring, like holding a piece of unpolished granite.
Well, that's done. And I nearly fell to sleep. We're gonna continue tomorrow. Make a manual save, and I'm bloody done for today. Guys, what's tomorrow? Saturday. It's gonna be streamed the entire day tomorrow. From the moment I wake up, I wanna finish with this and start with a new game. I'll need to find a new game also for tomorrow. Don't know what it's gonna be. But all in all, that's it for today. People, thanks for watching. I wish you all good night. See you back soon.